Hey there friends, welcome back to another new video in which I will tell you how you can mine cryptocurrencies on Android and is it profitable or not. I'm going to show you two ways to mine crypto on Android. First one with Termux application and second with an app directly from PlayStore. And then we will see if mining is profitable or not based on my results. So let's get started. First, let me show you how to mine crypto on Android with the help of Termux application. I'm going to clear the data of my Termux application so I can show you guys from the beginning. So it is clear now. Let me open my Termux. This is how it looks if you open it for the first time. The very first command we need to type is apt update so that the local list of packages will be updated. Don't skip this command or else you will get unable to locate package error while executing the next command, that is apt install. We need to install some packages, so type apt install git. First we will install git, then build essential, build build dash essential essential, and then the last one is cmake, and then give space and type dash y and hit enter. Need to get 71.4 MB of archive, so it can take few minutes to complete depending on your internet speed. And after it is completed, the next command is git clone. We need to clone one repository from GitHub, so type git clone. And then we need to clone this repository. Don't worry, link is in description, github.com/xmrig/xmrig. This XMRig repository in our Termux. So copy the link of our repository. I will provide all these commands on amanbears.com, don't worry about it. And then paste it here. And this will clone XMRig repository in our Termux. Do ls to see it, type ls, and then we see XMRig folder. Get inside that folder by cd command, cd XMRig. And here we need to create one folder named build. So type cd, not cd, mkdir, and then type build build. This will create new directory named build ls, and there is a build directory. Now get inside that directory using cd command, cd build build, build build. In this build directory, we are going to build our XMRig miner. So for that, type cmake space dot dot space dash, and in all capital letters type dwith underscore hwloc underscore hwloc equals off in capital letters equals off, give space and two ampersand to execute our next command, that is make dash j space, don't forget to give space, and then dollar sign, and in bracket type nproc and then close the bracket and hit enter. This will build XMRig miner in our Termux. It can take few minutes to complete. For me it took like 4 to 5 minutes. After the building process is completed, you can directly run XMRig miner, but before that you need to create one config file in your home directory. So switch back to home directory, and here you have to create one config file. But before that, let me show you what happens if you run XMRig miner without a config file. So let me get back to my build directory, that is in XMRig directory, and here is our XMRig file. So to execute it, simply type ./XMRig. As you can see here, we got an error, no valid configuration found. So first we need to create a configuration file in a home directory. So switch back to home directory using cd command, and here as you can see, by typing pwd you can confirm it if you are in home directory or not. I was in home directory. Now visit xmrig.com/wizard. See, let me type it, xmrig.com/, and here in this xmrig.com, if you will click on this wizard button, that is xmrig.com/wizard, this wizard will help you in creating a config file. So here all you have to do is to click on this new configuration button. In pool section, click on add pool, and then select any one of the listed pool. I will go with the first one, that is gntl.co.uk, and then enter your Monero wallet address. If you have a Binance account, you can get it from there, or if you don't have one, install this Monero Ujo app from Play Store and set up your Monero wallet. After it is done, paste your wallet address here, and then if you want, you can enter worker name too. I will enter my phone's name, that is POCOF1, and then click on add pool. After that, from this backend section, click on this backend section and make sure this CPU is enabled. CPU backend, use your CPU for mining, is enabled. And then in MISC section, you can set your donation level from 1% to 99%. You can't set your donation level below 1%. So make sure you have at least 1% of donation level, that is mining fees. And then at last, After you are done with everything, click on result and copy this code. See your config file code. This is a JSON file, so copy it. Let me copy it. Here we go, and then click on copy. And then switch back to our Termux application. Here, make sure you are in home directory, and then type nano. We are going to create one config file. So type this name, see, .xmrig.json. So type .xmrig.json, J-S-O-N, and hit enter. Here, paste the code that you have copied, and then do ctrl plus o to write out, and then hit enter, and then ctrl x to exit. Now, we have successfully created our config file. So move back to our build folder, and then run this XMRig mining software by /XMRig, and hit enter. And now our mining has started. I tried this mining for 4 to 5 hours, and then I got average speed of this, say, how many? The max speed was of 421 hashes per second, and then the average speed was 300 to 400 between that. So this was the average speed using XMRig miner in Termux application. Next is this React Native XMRig that you can download it from Play Store. All you have to do is to provide your wallet address and then simply click on start mining. That's it. And then the mining will start. And in settings section, if you will go here in settings, you can specify how many threads to use. Right now it is using 2 out of 8 threads, so you can increase it. Let me increase it to 6 threads. And then we need to restart our mining software, that is React Native XMRig, to see the changes. So let me close this application and then run it again. Now let me switch back to miner section and then start it again. Back then it was giving me 250 hashes per second with 2 threads. Now let's see what happens with 6 threads. As you can see now it is pretty improved. 900 hashes per second with 6 threads. Mining speed in this application is way more better than using XMRig in Termux. But if you will switch to rewards, you will see this. The mining fees is 19%. By the way, if you will keep mining, the mining fee will eventually reduce to 4%. But the good news is that while I was making this video, the developers of this React Native XMRig pushed an update. And in this new update, they removed the reward system, and now the mining fee is fixed, that is 3%. So using this application to mine on Android can be a better alternative than using Termux. But even though we are getting little good mining speed and mining fees is reduced too, is it profitable to mine on Android? There is only one way to find out. Visit this site, cryptocompare.com, and then click here and then click on mining calculator. Here by default there is Bitcoin, but we are mining Monero. And I was unable to find a button to change cryptocurrency. Let me know if you found one. So I made a little change in address bar. For Bitcoin, short form is BTC, and for Monero, short form is XMR. So I changed BTC to XMR in address section. XMR. What do you guys think? It will work or not? Let's see. It worked. Now our currency is Monero. Now let's enter our hashing power. That is, let's take an average of 700 hashes per second. So I will type 700 and then select hashes per second. After this, we need to enter power consumption. So I will enter 4 watts and then cost per kilowatt. So I will do it 0.7 and then pool fee, that will be 3%. So with these mining fees, mining speed and power consumption and cost, we will be making monthly profit of $1. So is it profitable? So in short, according to me, mining on Android is not profitable. If you want, you can try this for educational purpose to know more about cryptocurrencies. So what do you think about this? Let me know in comments. I hope you have found this video useful. See you in next one.